Okay, now this video is about the condition of the trees that are dying. And if you go to chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com, you can see all the photographs of what I'm about to show you and many other photographs. So we'll start with this little tree right here. Back in the very beginning of July, as the leaves were sprouting, this tree died after the rain. It never came back to life. And this is the way it stayed, with red leaves. The leaves turned white and red, or I should say yellow and red. Now the tree right next to it is almost in the same condition. After the same rainfall, it did the same thing. Only parts of its leaves sprouted. They stayed yellow, the little tiny little leaves, and the rest of the leaves didn't, none of this grew. So this tree is in pretty horrible condition. And now if you have a good look here, you'll see all the edges of the damaged leaves are dark. See, look like, if you look really carefully, that's not natural. This is from the rain. I'm gonna show you another tree. I'm gonna keep doing this and show you a whole bunch of examples. This tree here, it doesn't have very good color, but I'm gonna show you what the rain does. There's a spot right here in the tree that got hit by a really bad dose of what I call chemtrail pollution. So we'll zoom right in and show you how what happens to the leaves. Since this tree's pretty close, I'll be able to get a good zoom in here. See how all the outsides of the leaves are red? This is an acid rain. This is a lot more serious than acid rain. And people need to be really concerned because this is happening everywhere. I went around the city of Halifax and looked around. There's a spot here. I looked around and I saw this everywhere. These leaves are the same thing. This is the same tree, but this section of the tree didn't get hit as hard. Now, I'm gonna try not to take too long to do this, but I'm gonna show you around here. As you can see, I have a pretty good view of a lot of trees. And I have windows on the other side of my building, so I can see on the other side too. So I'm gonna show you many different things here. I'm gonna show you this tree right here. See how it's got all the brownish all over it? So take a look at this when we get really close. I hope you can hear me with the wind hitting my camera. So it's the same thing here. These leaves are damaged. And people might tell you this is only happening to maple trees. Actually, this is happening to all different kinds of trees. That's not a maple tree, this one. So now we're going to back off, and I'm going to show you the tree right next to it. And there's the tree next to it. If you look at all the colors of these trees, okay, look around. They're all different shades. Some have a blackish green to them. And this one here is in really bad shape. The leaves are only half developed. And it's dying, but it's like this everywhere. Once you start looking and paying attention to what's happening, you'll notice that the trees are all very, very unhealthy. So if you zoom in, you can see that the leaves are all damaged. And I'm gonna zoom back out. I'm gonna show you another tree. That every tree's got this problem. If you look around Halifax, this tree's losing all its leaves. This tree is really, really sick. The rain is doing this to the trees. Look at it, the whole tree. So I'll zoom right in again here so you can see the leaves up close. And I'm disabled, as you know, so it's really difficult for me to lean on this window to do this and hold this camera out the window. So this is a different type of tree with different kinds of leaves, and it's also all messed up. So I'll back up again and I'll show you. By the time I'm done with this, you're gonna understand what to look for when you're driving around and you're looking at all the trees. You have to look carefully. Like this tree here, it's the same thing. You can't see, it looks brown, but if you look up close, you'll see that the damage is on the leaves again here. See all the edges of the leaves, and the leaves are yellow instead of green. So I can keep going and going and going. There's damage pretty well. Every tree you can look at has got serious damage, but they're all discolored. That tree is all discolored, and it's got the same problem. This is a really, really serious problem. This is not acid rain. Acid rain just burns spots in leaves. And I picked this day right now because it's overcast and it's kind of cold doing this, but I figured you can see by, because it's not sunny, you get better contrast on the trees. So I'm gonna show you something. You look very carefully here, okay? See all the different colored trees? That's not natural. Last year when I looked out this window, all the trees had a beautiful bright green to them. Nothing yellow looking yellow. But if you look up close, all these trees are sick and dying everywhere you look. Look, everywhere, all of them. The whole city of Halifax is like this. I hope that you can hear me because the wind is hitting my camera and I'm talking pretty loud so you can hear me. So if you keep going and keep going all around Halifax, you'll notice that everywhere, and if there's this many trees in Halifax that are damaged, I can imagine this is happening all over the planet, because when I posted these pictures online, people were saying that they're having the same problem There's a tree here with only parts of it that was burnt by the rain. Okay, so we'll zoom in and show you what happens here. This is not because of fall. This is not a discoloration of fall. This is only August. The trees don't start changing color here for another 2 months. And this one here has really got a weird problem. You go up close and the leaves, now let the camera focus, the leaves are dying and they turn yellow when they die. That's not from fall. This is not fall. This is summertime here. And the leaves, like I said, don't change until October. And if we keep going and keep going, I could do this forever because every tree around here is damaged. This tree, the leaves are really small. And this tree's got the same problem. And I'm gonna keep going. If it was sunny, I suppose you might see it easier, but I want you to realize it's really overcast right now, but I want you to see that all the trees have this brownish look to them. When you go up close, you realize it's not just brown, it's red and black. Like the trees are bleeding. I mean, it's pretty gross when you look at all the leaves that are red on the outside, on the edges. It's everywhere. All the trees. I went around and I looked up close, and even the trees that look green, a lot of them, the leaves died while the trees were green, so the leaves are dried out. But this is not because of a problem with moisture, because this happened as soon as the trees sprouted in the end of June. I noticed that the colors of the trees was wrong this year, that a lot of the trees were not healthy. So this has been going on all summer, and all these trees have been losing their leaves all summer long. Trying to get a focus here. So now you're getting an idea, and there's nobody that can deny this video that I'm showing you, okay? If you look carefully, okay, I could go in, like that tree is burnt on one side here. I could go everywhere, but when you go up close, like that tree is kind of yellow right there, and that means the leaves are dead, and it's dark brown green on this side. This one's all burnt and dying. It's everywhere, guys. Look at this. Okay, look at everywhere you look. All you see is damaged trees everywhere. This is a really, really, really serious problem, and everybody really should be upset about this because the trees are the life of this planet. And these idiots that have been doing geoengineering and putting barium, aluminum, and strontium and other crap up in the air, well, that shit washes down in the rain and it's destroying our trees. But by the way, guys, this isn't just happening to trees. I went around to the public gardens in Halifax and I did pictures of the plants, the flowers, and all the bushes and everything, and evergreen trees. This is affecting all life forms that grow on the ground. Look at the color of these trees. That's not natural. This is not normal. These trees are like yellow. That's because the leaves are dead. They're dead on the edges. Everywhere you look. But if anybody wants to tell you I'm crazy, there you go. This tree is all burnt red, okay? Remember I gave a close-up earlier? I'll try to hold the camera steady because this is really far away and I'm leaning against the wall here and I'm getting in a lot of pain. So this is not natural. See, parts of the tree is red and parts is green. Don't let anybody tell you it's because of drought. There's no drought problem here. As you can see, the ground's all wet. I'll show you. It's been raining really good and it rains a lot here. So this is not the problem. This is not the problem. There's another dead tree. It's everywhere. So this video has been running for about 8 minutes. I'm gonna make it for 8 minutes and I'm gonna put it online so that you can see this, because photographs are good, but it's probably a lot better to see the videos. And I want you to tell everybody, I want you to call the environment department, everybody, show them this video and ask them what the hell's going on with all our trees. You know, not just the trees, remember, it's the plants. The farmers are having a lot of problem growing their crops because tomatoes won't grow. Like, these trees are dead. Look at them. Can you imagine next spring what's going to happen when none of these trees spray? My idea is that the trees are not going to sprout next year. Like, all that yellow is not natural. Trees are not supposed to be yellow. All the trees are all of them are damaged. And we'll get a little closer. We'll look at another tree here. You get yellow and brown. I mean, yellow and green on this one. But look across the street. Where is it? There it is. See the brown, and there's the green leaves, and there's the brown on this one. Let me show you. I'm going to zoom in. I want you to look at this again. This tree's closer so you can see what is happening to the leaves. And remember, have a look at the pictures I put online. You'll get to see these leaves up close. Can you see that? It's all the edges of the leaves. And the leaves are going green to red and yellow and die. And this tree across the street right here, it's the same thing. It used to be a really healthy tree last year, and it's practically dead. So keep looking, folks. Everywhere you look, look. Everywhere you look. It doesn't matter where I stick my camera. There's every tree's got damage. What the hell is going on? Why aren't people screaming in the streets that somebody's killing all our trees? It's not a drought. Don't let anybody believe you or tell you that for a second. This has nothing to do with drought conditions. Drought conditions don't turn the heads of the leaves red. Go have a look at all the pictures I put online, and please start speaking up and tell the government what's going on. We got to stop these guys from chemtrailing the skies. You may not know what chemtrails are, and I don't care if you watch too much TV and you have them telling you, oh, it's a bunch of kooks. Listen, guys, they've been geoengineering this planet since 1980, spreading out that chemtrail powder at altitudes of, like, you know, up over 100,000 feet. Clouds don't go up that high. Most of the shit you see in the sky in the daytime is not even clouds, and in the daytime, the skies aren't even white, aren't even blue anymore. They're now white because the sun lights up the microscopic particulates that they've been spraying up there, which are called barium, aluminum, and strontium, and many other things. So, folks, the lunatics who think they know better, the ones in the government or in the military, whatever, they're killing this planet. I mean, all they've been doing all through history for the last 100 years is killing and destroying countries all over the world and lying to us about everything. And everybody just kept turning their eyes the other way, or the other ones say, oh, it's not possible, and that's not true. Well, guess what, folks? It's coming home to roost now, because all these idiots and these lunatics you avoided and didn't want to talk about, they were destroying our planet. Well, here you go. You got evidence everywhere. Let's see if I can get the camera to focus here. I'm on camera. It takes a long time because I'm moving. Okay, let's move back up here. Oh, I've lost my focus really good. Okay, let me back up and let's get the focus back. There we go. It's hard to focus because it's not sunny and it's hazy outside. So, as you can see, as far as I can aim my camera, all you see is dead and damaged trees. I mean, look at that. You know, it's everywhere. This is not fall, folks. This is not from the season changing. This is summertime. This is August. And some people might say, oh, it's the heat. The heat doesn't turn leaves red. So, are you paying attention? Are you going to say something? Are you going to speak up and fight for your life? Because, folks, this is going to affect the whole planet. And it's going to get a lot worse because that shit that they put in the sky, the geoengineering, the chemtrailing they've been doing since 1980, they've had at least 300 drone jets flying around the sky that are remote controlled. They're white jets with no markings, and they've been spraying this shit, and they're also spraying it out of commercial aircraft. And, well, now, you know what? You want to be stupid and ignore the truth, and you want to ignore everything and think I'm crazy? You're the one that's crazy for not going out and finding out for yourself what the hell's going on and what's killing all the plants and the trees. Well, you know what? It's probably too late already, because I think the chemtrailing has already done a really good job of killing this planet. And those idiots with their HAARP program and their geoengineering is really the lunatics in the military using it for environmental warfare, causing earthquakes and all kinds of stuff. Do some research and find out. I'm not an idiot. You are, if you don't believe me, because you're not thinking for yourself. Go out and find out. This planet is being killed, and that's why I'm really upset, because I've been living in a world full of stupid people that never speak up and never fight for what matters. You know, like, you know, people will keep walking until they die because they don't care. The trees are all dying. What's next? We're going to be next. You going to do something about it for once in your life? Turn off your goddamn TV, go out and look at the trees, and go and tell your friends what's going on and get everybody talking? Fight for something in your life for once. Get off your ass.